On a remote outcrop of the Great Barrier Reef, a hawksbill turtle is released to play its part in a preservation study already years in the making.
Their numbers have to increase, otherwise they're going to be gone and we can't get them back.
This two-year-old turtle and another 10 have graduated from the hatchling raising tank at Townsville's James Cook University to the wilds of the reef, and traditional owners have been there from the beginning.
They want to integrate their knowledge, which goes back many, many thousands of years.
If we don't share what we have from what we've done traditional ways, then it's going to be lost forever.
As well as helping boost numbers on the reef, each released turtle is fitted with a tracking monitor and camera to try to fill in a 15-year gap in our turtle knowledge, basically from hatchling to egg-laying adult.
We just want to learn where they go and what they do. So in the lost years of hawksbills, we're not really sure which part of the reef they're inhabiting.
There's also concern about a chronic lack of boy turtles emerging from North Queensland nesting sites. One theory is that buried eggs are literally cooking due to climate change, causing a spike in female numbers while male hatchling numbers have plummeted. A short-term fix has been the cooling down of nesting sites with shade structures and hand irrigating. But scientists say cooling down the planet is the only long-term solution. Tim Collins for 10 News First.